Jindal. Today we'll discuss networking today. On part of CCNA course, first of all we are going to start today module 1, that is networking today. So it is basic introduction about our CCNA course. The basic objective of this course is to explain the advances in modern technologies, like how the networks affects our lives, network components, network representations and topologies, common types of networks, internet connections, reliable networks, network trends, security, how an IT professional will use the network or configure the network. Everything we are going to briefly understand in this module 1. Okay, let me take a few minutes to discuss about this. So first of all, networks affects our lives. See, you know, communication is almost as important to us as our reliance on air, water, food and shelter. In today's world, through the use of networks, we are connected like never before, right? It is very important thing in our life. If you remove the communication in our life, there is nothing. There is no Facebook, there is no Twitter, there is no Insta. Right. So communication plays a vital role in our day-to-day life. So for that communication, what are the different things we need? What are the reliable things we need? That we need to understand in this chapter. See, if you take our networks today, they have no boundaries and they are going to establish global communities, and we have human networks. So everything is possible today's networks. So if I want to establish all these things, what are the network components we require in these days? If you take network components, like basic network components, like before going to have a brief networking components, first of all we need to understand what is host and what is a guest. Okay. So there are many types of host tools are available in the day-to-day life in every computer network. Okay, so if you take a host or an end device, like our computers or desktops or laptops, every computer on a network is called a host or end device. And if you take a server or the computers that provide information to end devices, like we will see in our daily lives, like server and client environment, every client is going to get the information from the server. And we have several types of servers available: email server, web server and file server. Okay, clients are the computers that send requests to the servers to retrieve the information, right? If you see here, there is a picture which is showing each and every information, like what is an email server, what is a web server, what is a file server, and how to use these utilities in our day-to-day lives, right? And we are not here to how to use these tools. We are here to learn how these tools help the people by configured by the network administrators, how we are going to configure all these things to help others. Email server, how to configure this. Web server, how to configure this. File server, how to configure this. A network time protocol server, how to configure this. See, if any time we are going to call any particular person, a timestamp will be recorded when the person is called some X. Right, the duty of the timestamp recorded in the log server is maintained or configured by NTP server, network time protocol. Like everything we are going to understand in these networks. Now we'll see different components of the networks, like peer-to-peer components, means there is no client and server environment will be available here, only peer-to-peer connection, side-by-side connection is required, one end to other end, direct connection is required. There is no centralized administration. And if you take a security wise, it is not as much as secure as your client and server environment. And it's a peer-to-peer connection, we cannot integrate to n number of devices, it is not scalable and the performance will be very slower. Okay, because it is one-to-one communication, not one-to-all communication. It is recommended only in smaller networks like one or two computers or three computers. If it is greater than three or four computers, compulsory we need a client and server environment to get the reliability, to get the better performance, to get the security, to get the centralized administration, right? For all the things, we need to go for server and client instead of peer-to-peer connection. And if you take different types of end devices, I already told you client and server, clients are called end devices. They are going to get the services from the server. So every time an end device is seeking the service from a client server. Okay, so if you take different end devices like a desktop, a server, a mobile phone, an IP phone, everything will be like recognized as an end device. Generally, end device is where a message originates from or where it is received. Data originates with an end device, flows through the network and arrives at the end devices. So every time if I want to transfer any data from my workplace to other workplace, how I can transfer through network only? I can transfer. So this is my end device and this is my target device. If I want to transfer the data from here to here, I will use some intermediate devices. That is what internet work. Okay. And the devices which I am using in my local place are connected together. They are called as networking devices. Network of devices. Not networking devices. Network of devices. Okay. To combine these devices together in a centralized fashion, we are going to use a cable formatting between all the devices. Okay. And these are all the devices which are used to helpful for communication between host and destination, source and destination. So these are called network devices or inter-network devices. Okay. So these are the intermediary network devices like a wireless router, LAN switch, router, multi-layer switch, firewall appliances. These are all the intermediate devices which I am going to use in the communication. Okay, the basic use of these devices too is to regenerate and retransmit the data signals and maintain the information about the pathways which are existing in the network and notify if any other device of errors and communication failures. In these points, we are going to use all these devices. And we have network devices, we have end devices. How to connect these things? For that, we are going to have a proper cabling techniques. So in that, copper cables, fiber optic cables, wireless cables we are going to use. Okay. Generally, we are going to use metal wires within the cables, which uses electrical pulses, fiber optic cables, which uses pulses of light, wireless transmission system, which uses modulation techniques by transmitting electromagnetic waves. Okay, so first of all, network representation and topologies. We have different topologies. We can connect in networks in different fashions, right? So network diagrams, often called topology diagrams, use symbols to represent devices within the network. Okay, we have different representations of networks like end devices, intermediary devices, network media, and all those things combined together to form a topology. That is nothing but a network topology. Okay, for these things we need a basic components that are nothing but a network interface card NIC, a physical port on an intermediate device or on the end device, or an interface which is present on the intermediate devices. These are all the things we need to remember when we are going to discuss about the network representations. So these are the different topology diagrams we have, how we are going to connect. And let us consider this is our LAN network, contains three systems. And all these systems are going to connect to the other system which is present here with the help of internet or with the help of the intermediate devices. In between we use some cables. So this is nothing but a topology what we are going to use in a network. Okay. What are the common types of networks we are going to use in our day-to-day lives? A small home network comprises of one computer, one printer and one scanner. If you take a medium scale network, it contains a group of computers are settled in a floors or different floors in a single building. And a worldwide network is nothing but the network which is distributed to different areas over the world, and they are all going to connect with the help of WAN, that is nothing but wide area network. And the network which is sitting in a single room are distributed to two or three rooms are called as a local area network. Small home networks, small office or home office networks, medium to large office networks, and worldwide networks. LANs and WANs. Comparison: local area network and wide area network. Generally LAN, the area will be very less, and the WAN, the area will be very high, because it is going to combine different LANs together with the help of a cloud or internet. Okay. A LAN is a network infrastructure that spans a small geographical area. A WAN is a network infrastructure that spans a wide geographical area. The internet. The internet is a worldwide collection of interconnected LANs and WANs. LANs are connected to each other using WANs. WANs may use copper wires, fiber optic cables and wireless transmissions. Okay. There are some standards which we are going to connect all the devices together, are the cabling formats which we are going to use inside the networks, that is nothing but IETF, ICANN and IAB. Okay, and different types of networks according to their usage are different types of network their availability, that is nothing but internet, extranet and intranet. Intranet is the type of network which is available inside an organization or inside the home, which is available to a few persons or required persons. Extranet, it is available to internal network users and external network users, basically suppliers or customers or collaborators. That is nothing but extranet. And the other thing is internet, which is available to everyone, and it is nothing but a worldwide network. Okay. Internet connections. Basically, we are going to get the internet connections with the help of DSL modems or wireless WANs and mobile services, broadband cables. In the many formats, we are going to get the networks or internet, like VSAT, like a satellite connection. Through satellite also, we are going to get the internet in the rural areas where the network connectivity by the subscribers are not available. So, where we are going to use VSAT services. Okay. And nowadays, we are going to use ADSL modems in our home. Okay. Digital subscriber line or asynchronous digital subscriber line. Okay. And home and small office internet connections, how it should be. Cable, DSL modems, cellular connection, satellite, dial-up telephone connection. Cable, it is a basically high bandwidth, high speed connection which is offered by the television service provider. Okay, telephonic service providers. And DSL, it is digital subscriber line. It is also having a high bandwidth and the connection runs over a telephone line. Okay, and cellular connection. Cellular connection uses a mobile network to connect to the internet. Satellite, basically used in rural areas without ISPs. dial-up telephones, generally BSNL, it's a dial-up telephone connections previous days, an expensive and low bandwidth option using a modem. Inexpensive. It is very cheap and low bandwidth and easily available with the help of our landlines, which are available in our homes, using a modem, modulator and demodulator. So these are the basic representation of different connection media. In the business internet connections, we are going to use higher bandwidth and dedicated connections and managed services. Okay. Converging network. Converging networks are nothing but we are going to upload the different types of data through same network or cloud is called as a converging network or converged network. Like if you take a computer network or if you take a telephone network or if you take a broadcast network, any network, if we send a video signal or audio signal or any data signal, if we are sending through a single network, that type of network are called as a converging networks. See, medium, different types of mediums are going to send to a single cloud or single network is called as a converging network. Data, voice, video, or nothing, anything. Reliable networks. See, we have seen different types of networks, network representations, network models, and the type of cable, everything we are seeing, and we are establishing a network, assume. And after that, how the network should be? It is a fault tolerant network. It is a scalable network. It has a quality of service. It should be a secure network. Everything should be included in the network. Then only it is called as a reliable network. Okay, these are the basic four characteristics it should qualify. What is fault tolerance? Fault-tolerant network limits the impact of failure by limiting the number of affected devices. Like we are going to have loops in, then we can avoid the point of failures or single point of failures. If it is failure here, it is going to choose this path. If it is failure here, it is going to choose another path. Like that, compulsory there should be a backup path for every network to reach the internet. That is nothing but a fault-tolerant. Scalability. Nowadays, I have only this. This is the infrastructure I had. And without affecting this, if I want to increase my network capacity without disturbing my existing parameters, my network should support. That is nothing but scalability. A scalable network can expand quickly and easily, support new users and applications without impacting the performance of services to existing users. Okay, quality of service. Voice and live video transmissions requires higher expectations for those services being delivered. Quality of service is the primary mechanism used to ensure reliable delivery of content for all the users. Okay, like I need a video data and the X person needs audio data. So I will establish the quality of service between two different networks and I will serve only audio data to him and I will serve only video data to him by providing high bandwidth to this line and low bandwidth to that line. So with that, this person, the video who is watching, he will get a greater internet, a high bandwidth internet, and the audio, low bandwidth is okay, then he can able to listen the audio. For the audio, there is no need of high bandwidth. So that is nothing but quality of service. Instead of providing the same speed to all the lines, depending upon the service of the line, we are going to provide a good internet connectivity to that particular line. That is nothing but a quality of service. Network security. That is very much important in nowadays. We are going to identify three parameters when network security is coming into the picture. One is confidentiality, integrity and availability. Confidentiality is nothing but only intended recipients can read the data, not all others. Integrity, assurance that the data has not been altered during the transmission. Like if you take WhatsApp, end-to-end encryption, no one can putting the finger inside when we are going to send the data between one end to other end. Availability, assurance of timely and reliable access to the data for authorized users. The data will be available to only authorized users, not unauthorized users. We need to maintain the secrecy, and we need to maintain the integrity, and we need to maintain correctly availability data to correct authorized users only. Network trends like BYOD, like bring your own device, online collaboration tools, video communications, and cloud computing. We are going to use networks. Okay, laptops, notebooks, tablets, smartphones, and e-readers are comes into the bring your own device. Online collaboration tools are nothing but Cisco WebEx or Zoom or YouTube. Any platform if you take, that is nothing but network trend. Because we are going to group all the people with the help of apps through wireless. Video communications like video calls, WhatsApp video call, or any other like Duo, anything. And cloud computing. Cloud computing allows us to store personal files or backup our data on the servers or the internet. There are some servers which are situated on the internet. They will be used as some storage space for us virtually. We are not going to use our physical space. We are going to use a cloud space that is situated on the internet. Applications can also be accessed using the cloud, allows a business to deliver to any device anywhere in the world. Okay, cloud computing is made possible by data centers. Okay, generally there are different types of clouds are available: public clouds, private clouds, hybrid clouds, custom clouds. There are different clouds are available. If you take a public cloud, it will be available to general public through a pay-per-use model for free, like PPU. Private clouds intended for a specific organization or entity such as a government. Hybrid clouds made up of two or more cloud types, for example, part custom and part public. Each part remains a distinctive object, but both are connected using the same architecture. Custom clouds built to meet the needs of a specific industry such as healthcare or media. So some of the clouds they are going to design for some particular applications like healthcare or media applications, like any other like security applications, any other applications. Only it is dedicated to particular information, not used by all. So there are the some clouds which will be used by anyone, that is nothing but public clouds. Technology trends in the home. Okay, this is the basic technology how we are going to use from our home. Our mobile can mobile we can access our mobile, or we can access our car utilities by sitting inside our home with the help of IoT, Internet of Things. It is power line networking. Power line networking allows devices to connect to a LAN where data network cables or wireless communications are not a viable option. Okay, using a standard power line adapter, devices can connect to the LAN whenever there is an electrical outage by sending the data on certain frequencies. Okay, power line networking is especially useful when wireless access points cannot reach all the devices in the home. So this the nowadays power line networking is very useful option when we are going when we are not going to get the power point in our home. Okay, sorry, wireless access points in our home. This is wireless broadband, how we are going to use in our daily lives. Network security. We are going to get the network security with the help of firewalls or ACLs, access control lists, by restricting the unauthorized access to our network or unauthorized access to internet or anything. Okay, what are the threats which are available daily life, like viruses, worms, Trojan horses, spyware and adware, zero day attacks, three-factor attacks, denial of service attacks, data interception and theft, identity theft, internal threats, lost or stolen devices, accidental misuse by employees, malicious employees, like anything, external threats and internal threats. in the external threats, we have ransomware nowadays. They are going to steal our data and they are going to encrypt our data, and which is not decrypted in any tool. And they are going to ask ransom money from us. That is nothing but a ransomware attack. Security solutions. By using an antivirus or by using a firewall, we are going to filter the data and we are going to restrict the unauthorized access to our network. Security solutions. We can use a dedicated firewall system, or we can use an ACLs, or we can use an intrusion prevention system like IPS, or we can use a VPN. By using all these things, we can produce the security in our network. These are the basic solutions to network security. The IT professional. Okay, generally, if you are going to have a network, these are all what I am telling, a basic networking information. What is a networking, what is a network device and what it contains, what are the useful features when we are going to complete this course. Like, so these are the basic certifications which are available nowadays. CCNA, Cisco Certified Specialist, Cisco CCNP, Cisco Certified Network Professional, Cisco Certified Internet Work Expert. Like, different foundations will be there. One by one we are going to study all these things. Okay, and these are all DevNet courses. This is also very popular nowadays because we are going to automize everything. We are not going to touch any physical interface. We are automizing everything and we are going to configure everything by sitting remotely. That is nothing but DevNet. Okay, these are the basic courses which are available in the Cisco. See, networking jobs. There are plenty of jobs are available inside the, there are plenty of jobs are available over the market throughout the world. And nowadays, each and every company requires their own cloud space. And to maintain the cloud, we need a network administrator. And if they have a cloud and there is an internal network is available inside the company, to maintain the network, we need a network administrator. So if you take any kind of company like healthcare, medical, or security applications, military applications, or industrial applications, or educational institutions, compulsory they require a network, they require a network, and they require a network administrator to maintain that. So, and there is one option for the networking academy students. It internally contains a talent bridge matching engine. We can upload our resume and we can upload our skills in that, and it will display what are the jobs which are suitable to our profile by the Cisco or Cisco partners and distributors in the Cisco Networking Academy students and alumni students. Okay. That's it for our today's class. We'll finish.